Hi guys, welcome to another episode of How To Tutorials. I'm Super Sam, and in this very episode, I'm going to show you how to import your video reference into Blender without converting to an image sequence. Of course, you heard me right. And this process is very fast and easy to achieve in Blender. So here we are again in Blender, and to create my image plane for the reference, I would like to change from post mode to object mode. Make sure you're in object mode to do that. And using Shift A, that brings up this menu, and I'll go straight to the empty and click on image. So this creates an empty with an image icon. Empty objects with an image icon here in this list, and by clicking on the empty, I have the attributes to this empty object in here, and I'm gonna click on this. Yours might have something like this. Okay, just come here and click on this. Once you click on this, you can change the video sequence or image sequence you want to link to this image. But here in Blender, you don't have to convert to an image sequence before you can import it into your 3D environment to be used as reference. You can use your video clip the way it is, and that's what I'm going to do now. I'll click on this and go to my desktop where I have it saved, and here is the video. You can see .mp4, that's the file extension. So as soon as I click on this open image, I already have that in my scene. But what happened? Seems I can't see it in the scene. In Blender, it's very easy to locate your object. By clicking on the period key, that takes me straight to where the object is, and I can see that the object is very, very, very tiny compared to my character. I need to scale this up, and I'm gonna do that here by punching on the S key on my keyboard and dragging out. Once you're okay with the size of your objects, just click anywhere in your screen and the new object will be locked in. So this is the first step. Now the second step is to rotate this to make the image vertical. And here is my character. To bring my character in here, I'm going to use the short command G in order to have a free transform. And you can see period key to zoom in closer, and G to translate, G to translate, S to scale down, G to translate. So I have the video reference roughly where I want it to be, and by scrubbing here you can see the video reference plays with ease here in Blender, right? Okay, but there's something I want you to notice, to take note of. By the time I scrub past the 100th frame, my video freezes, and this is simply because my frames here says 100 frames. So that means any other frame over 100 frame would not be registered here. And to make this register, just click on this update icon. As soon as I click on that, Blender recalculates and gives me the exact frame number of this video, which is 7,198 in our case here. So now I can scrub past the 100th frame and still get feedback from my reference video. So this is how you can import an image reference into Blender without converting to an image sequence. And that wraps up this episode of How To Tutorials. So like the video, and remember to subscribe to our channel. And with this, I'm gonna sign out. Like.